Hey guys, what's up? My name is the Cool Mike and welcome back with another Critical Role episode review. So, this is episode 113, which is called The Final Ascent. So if you guys want to watch the episode, I'll be leaving the episode link in the description down below so you guys can go check it out. If you guys, here's the summary. Vox Machina, having made their final preparations, make their way to the top of the tower of Entropis with special guest Joe Magnello. I'm not sure how to pronounce that name. But yeah, so in the last episode, Vecna discovered that Vox Machina is closing in and is planning to kill him. So, Vox Machina had no other choice but to retreat back to the Feywild, where they met one of their friends, Artagan, which has a time spell that could would be advantageous to teleport them back to the giant undead titan. But in exchange, Artagan wants to kill Vax and see if he really is immortal. Which, surprisingly, Vax agrees. So, in this episode, they distribute the tremels. They have, I think, the tremels for the Raven Queen, Pelor, and Ayun. And I think Vexalia has the one for Pelor, and Vex has the Raven Queen, and Grog has the other. I think it would be better if they, the champion has the tremel. So I believe it would be better if Scanlan has the one for Ayun, but of course that won't be the possible because Scanlan has the book, the Tome of Isolation, the one that they need to trap Vecna. So, but I think it would have a better effect or probably an advantage if the champion for the specific god would be holding the tremel of that god. I just think that that would be smarter? I don't know. So they use Artagan's spell, time warping spell, which teleports them back to the undead titan, and they're in the city. And then there they saw Dragonborn in armor fighting a Gloomstalker, and it appears that Dragonborn is called Archon. So if you guys don't know what Archon looks like, that's what Archon looks like. And he was fighting a Gloomstalker, which is the flying creatures in the city of Taramphala. And when he sees Vox Machina, he tells Vox Machina not to kill the Gloomstalker as he was planning to ride it. So once Archon manages to grapple the Gloomstalker with the help of Vox Machina, and he puts a necklace on the Gloomstalker, the Gloomstalker begins to calm down, and it appears that the necklace was able to control the Gloomstalker. So now the Gloomstalker is on their side. So it appears that this Archon knows Percy and killed it 2 years ago, surprisingly. And at the same time, this Dragonborn is a servant to Tiamat. Tiamat, that was called Dragon, I believe. So yeah, Tiamat. So Tiamat, the Skulled Tyrant Dragon, which Archon calls his queen. And if you guys don't know what Tiamat looks like, this is what Tiamat looks like. He is a five-headed dragon, I believe. So he's a five-headed dragon god. So that's what Tiamat looks like. They come face to face with Lady and Lord Briarwoods, along with the giant dragon, the skeleton dragon that they encountered in the previous episode. It appears that the skeleton dragon is Archon's mount, I believe. So they tried to face to face, where in this battle they managed to kill Lady Briarwood. But Lord Briarwood escaped, turning into a mist, and manages to escape from their Vox Machina's grasp. when Lady Barwood was killed by Vexalia, because it was Vexalia who kills Lady Barwood, Lord Barwood wasn't happy and has no other choice but to retreat. And the skeleton dragon, dies as well. It turns out that Lady Barwood is the one keeping the skeleton dragon alive. So once Lady Briarwood was killed, the skeleton dragon also pulled apart and now becomes powerless against Vox Machina. So they use the Robe of Entanglement and the blue crystal that they found in the City of Undead Dwarves as it appears that this crystal is... I think I forgot to mention this in the last episode, but Artagon mentioned that this crystal is a crystal that can use to attract undead, and I think the crystal is called, let me just check. Oh, so the crystal appears to be a pole stone, which is used to attract or disrupt the undead, and they use that to disrupt the giant zombie guarding the tower, the obelisk tower where Vecna is. And I also forgot to mention in the previous episode that Artagon also wants a doorway to their realm or to their plane in exchange for his services, as well as the time warping magic that he's gonna do to teleport them back to the giant undead titan. So after that, they go to the tower after distracting the giant undead using the pole stone that they got in the zombie dwarven infested city. Pike use a turn undead, killing most of the zombies. As they avoid a bunch of traps, they go closer and closer to the top of the tower where they saw three guards. And this is my favorite part of the episode, and you will know why. I'm pretty sure you guys already know why this is my favorite part of the episode. It appears that those three guards, as they try to stealthily kill them, Vex and Vex kills one guard each, and Archon tries to kill the last guard in the middle. At first attack, he misses, and then for some reason, when he tries to attack again, the guard just accepts the blow and does not move, just staring blankly in the air at him, through him. When Vexalia removes the helmets, it appears that the guard, the one in the middle, is none other than Gilmore himself, so one of their friends. And as they inspect the bodies, as Pike tries to inspect the bodies, the two bodies that Vex and Vex killed, the two guards, appears to be Cassandra, Percy's sister, and Kaylee, Scanlan's daughter. So they got shocked, they had no idea what to do, they start panicking, and Pike had no other choice but to resurrect the two girls upon Scanlan's request. So they resurrect, they revivify, casting the spell revivify, revivify on both Kaylee and Cassandra, who were both unconscious. And of course, at first they were hesitant because it could be a trap or an illusion, at least that's what Pike mentioned. And once they tried to remove the bands, because they were wearing a golden band, Gilmore was wearing one, and then Cassandra and Kaylee was also wearing one. When Pike removes it, Gilmore goes back to normal, or should I say, gets control of his body, and he has no idea where he is, and it's as if the gold band is like some sort of magical object that prevents them from becoming, that keeps them hypnotized of some sort. And of course, it appears that he appears to be the real Gilmore, as Vexalia tries to do an inside check on Gilmore. So, Pike had to revivify Kaylee and Cassandra, which was important in their battle, and of course, they had no other choice because that was their family. And Vex tells Gilmore to teleport them out of here. Take the two girls and teleport them out of here, after explaining to them what happened. So it appears that when Gilmore told them that he was teleported by some sort of magical doorway that appears in his workshop. Probably the same thing happened to Cassandra and Kaylee at some point. So yeah, pretty much that's that. And then they hear a bunch of footsteps where the Dark Knight, the one they fought before, along with a bunch of cultists, tries to surround them. And then Arkhan, the Dragonborn, interferes and tries to stop the Dark Knight. And a bunch of the cultists, as Vox Machina goes to the top of the tower to face Vecna. So yeah, pretty much that's what happened in this episode. If you guys enjoyed, leave a like. Also, don't forget to subscribe now if you haven't. If you guys want to watch the episode, I'll be leaving the episode link in the description down below so you guys can go watch them. And as always, I will see you guys next time with another brand new video. This is The Cool Mike signing off. Goodbye.